Hi everyone, this is Belal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. In the last video, we learned a manual approach of doing dependency injection in our Android project, and we did it by generating the app container and factories ourselves. We also discussed the problems that we have with the manual approach of dependency injection. And that is why, to simplify the things, we will use Dagger for dependency injection in our project. So the first question is, what is Dagger? Dagger is a fully static compile time dependency injection framework for Java, Kotlin, and Android. As we discussed, manual dependency injection can be problematic if our app size grows. To avoid or eliminate the complexity of manual dependency injection, we can use Dagger to handle dependencies. Dagger works at compile time. That means it automatically generates the required code for dependency injection that we have to write by hand if we do not use Dagger. The benefit of using Dagger are, it generates the app container automatically at compile time that we created manually in the last video. It creates factories for the classes available in the application graph to satisfy dependencies. Dagger can decide whether to reuse an existing instance or create a new instance with the help of scopes. And we can easily create containers for specific flows in Dagger with minimal boilerplate code. Now let's see a sample use case according to the current project that we are working on. In our current project, we have an authentication flow. And for this flow, we have auth view model that requires auth repository, and auth repository requires auth API and user preferences. So auth repo is dependency for view model, and auth API and user preferences are the dependencies for auth repo. Now here we have defined auth view model like this, but currently Dagger do not know how to create auth view model, and that is why we need to tell the Dagger with the @inject annotation that you have to create this dependency. And now Dagger knows that it has to build auth view model. But again, the auth view model requires auth repository, and Dagger do not know how to build auth repository. And that is why again we need to tell Dagger with the help of @inject annotation that hey, you have to build this dependency as well. I hope you got the point. After this, we have Dagger component that makes a graph for dependencies. To create a component, we just create an interface and annotate it with @component. Inside the interface, we define the functions with the return type, and rest of the thing Dagger will do automatically. Now when we will get the repository from the graph, it will give a new instance every time, but it is not necessary, and sometimes we require same instance of the dependency. For example, we need a singleton instance sometimes, especially when we are using the same instance in many places. We can achieve this thing by scoping. That means we need to tell Dagger that hey, I need a singleton instance of this thing. And we can do it with the help of singleton annotation. Sometimes we need to create dependency that is required for a specific flow. For example, we created the auth view model for the authentication flow in the last video. We can achieve this thing by creating our own custom scopes for a specific flow. And we will learn all these things in coming videos. If you found this video helpful and learned something, from the next video, we will start implementing Dagger in our project. Meanwhile, please do subscribe to my channel if you're not already a subscriber. And if you want to get in touch with me, then you can follow me at Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter. So thanks for watching everyone. This is Belal Khan now signing off.